Hello friends, welcome to my video. In this video, I will show you a sorting mechanism for a series of numbers. In this video, I'll show you to do bubble sort using a recursive method in MATLAB function. So before we proceed, let's first try to understand the bubble sort. So for that, I have opened this wiki page of bubble sort. So what you can do is you can go through it and try to understand what does the bubble sort do. I'll just try to explain what does in bubble sort it happens is, say for example, if this is the series of number you are trying to sort, so it will first take, it will take two numbers at one point of time, and whichever number is greater, it will just shift it to the right hand side. And in this series, it will just scan it for the complete list of the numbers unless it reaches to the last. Once done for the first time, then it will place the highest number at the last, and it will do the same process for the complete list except for the last one, because we have already sorted the last one. So this way, this recursively, it keeps on doing this. So that's why recursive approach is the best approach to do the sorting, because you can just quickly reuse the algorithm for the sorting of this pair of numbers in the recursive function. So let's start. So let's go to the MATLAB and create one of the function, MATLAB function. Let's name it bubble sort. Input, we just need one input. It will x, so it will be a vector of numbers, and it will give an output y. We don't need any of these things. So let's start. So let me just save it, bubble sort .m. So first, what we have to do is, if I go back to my this diagram, we have to first get the complete length of the number of how many numbers are there, the count of the numbers. So that we can get using the length command in MATLAB. So length of x, so I can assign it to n. And once we have the length, then we have to do a kind of iteration. So for I equal to 1 to n, I think not n, it will be n minus 1, because what we have to do is we have to scan it till the last. So we will start from the first and we will take the first and second. So we have to go for till n minus 1. And once we have that n minus 1, what we have to do is, now we should compare whether if x of, I think if x of I is greater than x of I plus 1, then what should we should do is, we should, okay, I think after if we should have given this, we should do is swap. And to swap, I will use a simple swapping. I will not go for the fancy swapping algorithm. They are separate swapping algorithm as well. But for this example, I will concentrate on bubble sort and use a simple swapping algorithm. So I use the temp equal to, say for example, x of I, x of I equal to x of I plus 1, and then x of I plus 1 equals to temp. Right. So we are swapping the numbers, and I think that's done. Okay, yeah. So once we are done, we can just end our for loop. So that's done. So this, in this for loop, what we will be doing is, we will be taking these two numbers at one point of time, we will compare and we will proceed. So once that part is done, what we have to do is, we have to call this method or this function in a recursive approach. So for that, what we can do is, we can call this bubble sort recursively by calling this x1, and this time we will just pass it the n minus 1 digits, not the complete, and of course the output should come in a y. So the output of this we are taking recursively as a y here. So in relation text, okay, I think one more this is missing. No, it's fine. Yeah, So over here, if you notice, we are not passing the complete x, but we are passing till n minus 1. We are removing one of those. Okay, but one thing we have to note is before we proceed into for loop, we should make sure that there is some return mechanism for this, because in recursive that's very important, recursive function concept, if you are aware of, then we have to put a return condition on top. So let's put that. So that will be condition when our n will be less than 2, because if there is only one element, then we don't need to sort it, because then y will be simply equal to x and we can return. So I'll just put a comment also, as a good programming practice, I'll just return condition check in a recursive function. Okay, so once we have this return, so okay, so here what the y value will we will get is, say for example, if you have only one element, so to return that one element, but we have to concatenate the last element here. So what that we can quickly do is the final y will be y equal to y, because this y will be the value which we got in line number 21 over here. So this will be this y, and we have to concatenate it to the last value of the n of the x, which we can get through this n. Yes, so I think when we have this, this should be fine. So yes, I save it. I think our code is complete. Yes, so we can now see the complete one. Now let's call this function. So we will assign, we will first create a random vector. So 3, 1, 4, 6, 8, 9, 2. So once we have it, so this is my randomly selected array u, and now I will call this bubble sort with this as an input, and let's see what it happened. Perfect. So if you see it did sort it out 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. You can of course debug it by putting a breakpoint and then see so like we can put a breakpoint and see how it happens at what point of time, which particular number or array it's taking, please watch my debugging video to get more details on how to do the debugging. In this video I'll just focus on my bubble sort. So this is a very simple code of how to do a bubble sort. We can probably take another example before I end it, and I will take, say for example, I'll make it much more bigger. I'll take complex number 1.0 minus 2 3.4 9 121 minus 2.22 pi 3.41. So let's see if it does it or not. Perfect. So even it did for pi also, if you are able to see it. So it's able to do it for pi. So no, so it resolves this pi value to this 3.146. So we can call this algorithm again with this u, and yeah, if you notice, we got the sorted value of 2. So it doesn't matter whether it's a rational number, irrational number, this negative or integer, it is sorting it out. Okay, then thank you for watching my video. If you have any questions, please put it in my comment section, and if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye.